what we're doing here is bring us your bugs. In fact, this is the second event that we have put on this year. The idea is to invite the people of Adelaide to find bugs in their backyards, collect them for us, and bring them in here. And we've had lots of people. We've had about 1,500 people through today who collected all sorts of different animals.
There are lots of kids around, lots of people, people bringing in bugs to not just to have identified, but also to add to the collections of the museum. A whole lot of children here experiencing science firsthand.
I've got a brown praying mantis. And he's staying still because he's pretty hungry.
A springtail, which is somewhere, two earwigs, two slugs, two slithers, one centipede, a snail and a beetle.
Green praying mantis, he's only young, and I've also got two praying mantis egg cases.
Four snails, one beetle, two slugs and a millipede.
One red millipede and one slider beetle.
They have had their animals identified. They have got show bags and rewards if they brought in some special animals.
I learned that this was a common house centipede that the Americans call a Johnny Hundred Legs.
I used to drive my mother and the museum there quite mad by taking mainly rocks, some bugs. Rocks didn't bite back, so I favoured those, into the museum. To have them identified and to talk to the people working at the museum, and they were always very, very patient, and I can say that encouraged me very much to go into a science career. So I hope we see that happening around us as we speak.
We've also been photographing them because we're producing a book called The Wildlife of Greater Adelaide, and we wanted to get a good collection of the invertebrates of Adelaide, animals without backbones. And the only way really to do this is to get the community to collect them.
Oh, just look inside. Look inside. They're really weird.
Look inside.
That's
freaky.
That's the magnifier.
It's not just good enough to be passionate about the environment. You also need to know something about it, and there's not any stage that's too early to learn, and the university certainly is very committed to seeing more science awareness and interest, so that we can inspire young people to go into science as a career, but also, as I said, to understand the scientific background a bit more.
We're one of the very few universities around the world which actually has their students actively engaged in community activities like this on a regular basis, and that's really what makes UniSA very special in my view.
I'm studying Sustainable Environments, Biodiversity and Park Management. It's a fantastic course, all about plants and animals and ecosystems. The more practical experience you do, really, the likelihood of you getting a job that you adore is a lot higher.
We really need to engage kids to demonstrate that there is a fabulous environment, there's wonderful animals. Participate, get involved, and then you can conserve them for later generations.